There wasn't a huge weight loss, but there was no weight gain either. So get net for net and go, yeah, I'm gonna go on vacation, I'm gonna try to eat responsibly, but I'm not gonna be a maniac about it. Hey guys, welcome back. So today is the end of week two on my semaglutide weight loss journey. And we have some tea, we have some things to talk about. We don't really have a lot of progress to talk about though. So let me get the numbers out of the way because that's what I always wanna know. Last Friday, 180.2. My video is over on TikTok. Then you know that much earlier this week, I dropped down into the 170s and I think I got as low as like 178.4. Follow me over there if you wanna see those daily updates. But as you know, weight loss journeys have it. Of course, this did not stay. So this morning I woke up, of course, on the day that I filmed my update video, right? And I was 179.8. Which, like I said in my TikTok earlier today, would only have been more terrifying if I was back in the 180s. So let's talk about some of the things that I think may contribute to that. I don't really know. We're all just figuring this out as we go. I want to talk about three things in this video. My dosing, I'm starting with, and what their original treatment plan is for me. Intuitive eating that I did this week, and then the sort of non-skill type tools that I'm using to help me assess, am I moving in the right direction? Watch my video from last week, which I'll link at the end of this video. I was very, you know, by the books, right? Kind of dialed in my old like bikini bodybuilder self, and I was checking every single macro and every calorie and every. And I did that and I had great data at the end of last week. This week, I decided I'm gonna try to eat a little bit more intuitively, not log every single thing because I just don't wanna become a log monkey again. I mean, if I have to, I have to, but I've been doing it for the last couple of years, so what? I mean, I feel like after you've been doing it for this long, you should be able to eat intuitively and know basically that you're hitting your macros. That said, that was really the only difference this week. Didn't log every single thing. I was just kind of doing it off the cuff, kind of eating when I felt hungry, so stop eating when I felt satisfied. So let me go back to last week. So last week I felt like I was not hungry at all. Like I take my shots on Sunday night and I was not hungry at all really until like maybe late Wednesday or Thursday. I will say this week I was hungry again by like Tuesday evening. So for whatever reason, if you're further along in this journey, leave it in the comments below. Let me know. I don't understand that, but it seemed like the shot only worked for like 2 days today as far as appetite suppression. So it's not like I went out and had McDonald's or Smoothie King shit. I didn't. I mean, I just ate the same kind of stuff that I always eat, which is I prepare literally all of my own meals. So I am a little baffled by why I'm jumping up and down like this week. But guys, weight loss is not a linear process, okay? I can tell you going into competition prep many times as a bikini bodybuilder that, I mean, your weight will be doing all manner of things and it'll make you crazy. Outside of this process, I would not be weighing myself every single day. I'm doing that mostly for y'all, right? Because I want people to be able to see like, hey, you can't throw the towel in and just decide, you know, drop your pack and say, I'm done with this if you have a rough week, because you're gonna have some rough months maybe. And every single day is not gonna be a victory. And conviction and your dedication to this process, to you, has to be deeper than that. So the reason I weigh in every day and share that with you guys is because I want other people to see totally normal, nothing to freak out about, part of the process, it's cool, let it go, look around, stay the course, and you're gonna get there. Okay. And in these videos at the end of the week, I try to kind of hit on the questions that I got the most from my TikTok videos this past week. So dosing was a big thing that I kept getting questions about. All right, I am new to GLP-1s. I have only ever tried semaglutide, and this is only the end of week two for me. So that, for what it's worth, give my neighbor's ginormous truck, which you can probably hear, it's like so loud, it literally rattles my bedroom. I started this process with MinuteMD, who I have some thoughts about. We'll save that for another video. The verdict's not in for me with them. But so I started at 0.25 milligrams, that's the strength, and 5 units for the first 4 shots, and then 10 units for next month's shots, each shot 10 units. And then the third month would be 20 units each shot. So basically doubling every single month. Now, I don't know if that's a normal dosing schedule, but that is mine. And I did send an email to MinuteMD and ask them like, hey, can you kind of help clarify for me why some people reach out to me and say, hey, my dosing schedule started here, yours is here, why? And the truth is, I'm not 100% sure that is an area where there could be more clarity. So I did send them repeated emails. MinuteMD, if you're watching, customer experience is a thing. Oh, customer service is also a thing. Respond to that email so that I could in the class, and nobody would be upset about that. But I will touch on that because I am there right now. MinuteMD was very responsive in the beginning, and you know, now that like we're in the mix, I will say that I've sent like 4 emails that have not been responded to. And I don't love that. Now, if you don't know me and my like outside of this particular channel, which is brand new in my real life, you know, I'm a customer experience designer. So customer experience is like a big deal to me. And if they don't clean that up, look, there are no shortage of semaglutide providers. I'll just leave it there for right now. We'll come back to that when there's more to come back to. Intuitive eating is when, you know, you think you know your macros, so you're just not tracking every single little thing. And you're just kind of trying to eat according to what you think is your macro plan. From this past week, this was an epic fail. I mean, the proof is in the pudding, right? Like my weight went from, like I said, last Friday, 180.4 to today, 179.8. And did we dip down below that? Yes, of course. But net for net, that's a 0.4 pound weight loss in a week, which is not, like, it will take me 932 years to lose the weight at that point. So we're gonna have to dial that in a little bit. Still, all in all, it's 5.2 pounds down. I started with 60 pounds to lose. That means I have 54.8 to lose. So perspective, touched on this earlier in the week over on my TikTok. If I had lost 5 pounds before semaglutide in 2 weeks, I'd have been over the flipping moon, okay? You know, you get greedy, you want to lose it faster, which of course I do. But that's what it is. That's where I'm at right now. I'm not going to be doing intuitive eating next week because even though, and you guys on this channel, you are going to see me kind of tweaking things up and down a little bit because I want to know how certain variables affect this process because I think that's valuable information, not just for me, but for anybody else. Because guys, I mean, we're not all, like if you go on vacation, you're not gonna be tracking every single macro. If you are, you're gonna be miserable. You might just have to decide for yourself, like, okay, you know, it's a zero. There wasn't a huge weight loss, but there was no weight gain either. So get net for net and go, yeah, I'm gonna go on vacation. I'm gonna try to eat responsibly, but I'm not gonna be a maniac about it. And then I wanted to talk about some like non-scale victories, okay? And next Tuesday, I'm gonna talk about 5 must-have weight loss journey tools. These are tools that I have leaned on every single time that I've gone into competition prep when dropping weight and tightening things up is that's what I'll go to next Tuesday. But today, so obviously guys, scale victories are great, right? And this scale, this is my ride or die. She's my queen. I love this scale. Then when you step on it, it feeds all the information into the app, which means that I can go in here at any time and I can see my progress over time. It tells you like, tells you your body fat percentage, your bone, that all, it tells you so many factors that are incredibly important with respect to weight loss. Renfo is the brand. And guys, of course, I'll leave it linked down below. I've had that forever. And also this, which is made, these are all 3 made by the same company. And no, this is not a sponsored post. This, okay, do your measurement. Also feeds into the same app. So just making it easier to keep track, right? Then I can see every single thing, okay? And this, which is the newest edition, and this is the one I wanted to talk about for what I'm gonna do next week, is the food scale, which I bought because I just love those other 2 products. Again, same company, Renfo. And when you put your food on the scale in the app, you just enter what it is and it will feed the macros straight into the app. Well, you have your macros, your measurements, your weight, everything going into the same app. I am so flipping here for this. I have enjoyed those other 2 products so much that when I saw this food scale, I was like, yeah, we're gonna need to do that. They even have like a blood pressure monitor, which I will have to get because I like have some weird obsession with this company. I just love their products. For next week, this is what I'm really gonna go back to, kind of dialing in my macros, because even though I thought I had it straight, I mean, now it could just be an anomaly where I just did not have a large loss week. I mean, I guess that happens, you plateau sometimes. Or it was that I was eating more than I thought I was, which is totally possible because again, I was pretty hungry. Guys, I wasn't sitting down like, you know, going ham on a bag of chips. And again, I didn't go to like McDonald's or Burger King, nothing like that. Even inside the confines of your own home, eating clean food, you can overeat or you can eat too much of a certain food that isn't gonna work for you. Me personally, because I've tracked my macros for like 900 years, I know I can't eat a lot of carbs. My body does not respond well to carbs. Now I'm not like a carb Nazi and I'm not like, oh, never a carb. I do try to keep it below like 20 carbs a day. And then once a week, I do push up over 50 carbs. It's called carb cycling to kind of give you that metabolic, you know, slap to sort of reset your body. But I am gonna be, I'm gonna be more like methodical this week using this new scale And those products are part of, that's, I count those as one product out of the five tools that I'm going to talk about next Tuesday. These are all for me, like ride or die tools, must have. I had a food scale before I got this the other day. It just didn't log into the app. So yeah, we got to spoil ourselves.
It's not my fault.
You like nice things.
Yeah. You know exactly who I am.
I think all in all, I'm not as like thrilled as I was last week because of course I don't have the numbers that I want. Guys, I mean, I continue to have no nausea, no trouble resting, no headaches. I mean, nothing. If I'm being completely fair, I wasn't excellent this week about drinking water. Now that I'm sitting here thinking through the week, I just wasn't great about it. I filmed a lot more than I normally do this week. And water, like nothing new there. I'm still drinking the electrolytes and BCAAs that I'm constantly talking about because I swear to you, that's why I've had zero side effects. I just have had no side effects, including this week, weight loss. So yeah, guys, that's where we're at this week. I mean, you know, not every week is going to be a, woo, I lost, you know, 7 pounds. Those weeks will come. I am certain of that. I have not been through this process enough to know. I had my kids and had to lose weight, or when I was coming up for a show and had to lose weight. I have been through this experience of weight loss multiple times, never with the assistance of semaglutide, but with all these other data points and all these other tools. So I know that the weight will come off. I'm not worried about that because, and here's how I know. Because for the last 3 years, I really have done all the same things that I've done for the last 2 weeks. The difference is I'm actually losing weight now. So my faith in semaglutide is completely intact. You know, I think sometimes you just have an off week. I was looking through some of my other training journals and there were some weeks where my weight went up consistently 2 and 3 weeks in a row and then a huge drop. Take it as a data point and don't internalize it and just move on with your life and just go, okay, you know, whatever. That number is, we're not friends. And then just go right on down the path and lose your way because the numbers aren't going in your direction. You know, I'm talking to you as much as I'm talking to me. Process. I know everybody says that and it sounds so cliche, but it is. It's, I mean, not only is it a process, which it is, it's a journey. Enjoy it. Enjoy the good days so that when the bad days come, you can go, yeah, okay. Work in corporate sales like 100 years ago when I lived in Los Angeles. And they used to say, and damn, this was so true. They would say, it takes seven to nine no's to get to a yes. Or I embraced that concept. I would always feel so gross every time I got a no from a client. I would feel like, oh, like I'm a failure. I just, you know, I'm not a good enough salesperson to sell them. When I said, no, it's a numbers game. Seven to nine no's gets a yes. Then I was just like, okay, no, boom. That's one less no that I need to get to my next yes. On the journey of weight loss, you're going to have some crap days. This is a crap day for me. I know on whole, there are going to be more good days than bad days. So I just go, okay, crap day, cool, you're here, which means set up for quite a few good days. Just try to look at it like that. And I just, you know, don't worry about it. Don't internalize it. Don't make more of it than it is. And certainly don't use it as an excuse to quit because then you'll be right back where you were, but then you'll be pissed off and frustrated at yourself because you wasted all that money, a GLP-1, a semaglutide, or whatever it is you're on, and then you'll just be like, what did I do any of this for? And then you'll have to start all over. We're not doing that, okay? If you guys enjoy videos like this because you are on a weight loss journey or you are thinking about going on a weight loss journey or you know someone who is, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share with a skinny friend, and yes, all my videos, you see it drops in and it says, hey, skinny squad. And no, I'm not fat shaming. And yes, I feel like I have to say this at the end of every video. I'm not fat shaming, guys. I'm not skinny right now. But my goal is to become a lean version of myself. And you gotta have a goal. Rates of hitting your target go up exponentially when you aim at it. That's why I say skinny, skinny squad. I mean, my girlfriends and I used to joke around and say, oh, you're a skinny little bitch. You know? And that holds some happy memory and happy place for me, and that's why I say it. Welcome to the skinny squad. You guys, keep your chin up. Let me know how you're doing. Let me know if you hit your goals this week. I celebrate victories for other people, even if I didn't personally have them, because it helps everyone see. See? This person had a good week, you had a bad week. It's fine. It all works out in the end. All right. Well, I will see you guys on Tuesday for those five must-have tools for a weight loss journey. Have a great weekend. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.